Welcome to How It Works with Holger for a very special episode. Today we're looking at the labs of Google Chrome and something very, very exciting. I was blown away, so I recorded this video right away because Google Chrome now includes AI, an AI chatbot that you can access inside of the browser, and that means inside of all your web applications. This is really, really cool. And you can try it out with a few simple things that you have to install on your computer. If you have a Mac, this is excruciatingly easy to do. You need to download the Google Chrome for Developers. That's the first step. I'm going to do that right here. And downloading that allows you to access features that might not be in the production Chrome yet, so that you have access to the new features. And in addition to that, you now have to configure this Google Chrome dev in a certain way that you can use these new AI features. And again, the cool thing is you can integrate this AI chatbot or the replies from the AI chatbot into anything, meaning anything where you have a Chrome web browser. So also if you use TMS technology, for example, that has the Chromium support integrated, you can access these results in your application. And of course, as a TMS Web Core developer, this is really, really exciting because you can also provide AI solutions to problems on demand. And also, this works offline, meaning the model is being downloaded into the browser and it is not exchanging any information with any servers. The downside right now, it is pretty basic, meaning that the replies sometimes are simply wrong, and Google has a lot of work to do to get this a little bit more sophisticated. They use the Gemini AI, and it is one of their first tries, I would say. That's why we have to jump through some hoops to activate it, but it's not that difficult after all. So I go to my downloads here and look in here. I get the Google Chrome Dev DMG. I can install this. This gives me this window and I can drag it into my applications. That's how you install applications on a Mac if you've never seen this before. So we're copying it into my applications. And now I can start Google Chrome for the developers. And it's coming up right here. Right now it's verifying it. Yes, I really want to open it. And here's my new Google Chrome. I don't sign in right now. I just want to keep it as is without having any specific configuration in there. Obviously, I get all the security notifications. This is like a different product if you install it. This has its own environment. It's a development environment. If I go to this URL, I get the Next.js Chrome AI chatbot. So somebody already implemented this inside of the browser so that we can try it out. I will, however, try it out in the console of the browser. But in order to see what you need to install, this is the cool thing, please enable flags. So how it works, they tell you here, this is the example, but here necessary experimental flags, that's the thing I wanted to have. So we need to go here, copy paste, open up a new tag, paste, and then prompt API for Gemini Nano, I set this to enabled. Then we need to relaunch. And after doing that, then we need to go to optimization guide on device model. We need to find this. This has turned out to be very tough to find. So I'm trying to optimize, typing optimize right there. Here it is, enables optimization guide on device. So I'm going here and I'm setting it to enabled bypass. Perfect, relaunch. We're almost there. And then we go to the last one. We go to Chrome components. Again, we paste this in here. And then you have to look for the optimization guide on device. That means that you download the AI model into your browser, that it is getting saved into your browser. That's the cool thing. So you can be offline. It will be part of your Chrome browser, of this browser. And then you can use it from anywhere. I'm going to wait a little bit until it is downloaded. It is huge. So on my 500 megabit It takes at least 5 to 10 minutes to download. So also make sure that you have hard disk space available, that your virtual machine, for example, where you test this on, is not too small. And as soon as the download is complete, I'm going to continue with the demo. As soon as the download is done, you get the version number right here, version 2024.6.5.22.05, and component already up to date. Perfect. Now I'm going to restart the whole thing again. So I'm going to quit this. And now the AI stuff should be available. We can test this pretty easily by going into the... First of all, you can do this. You can copy this URL again and then go into your browser and type it in. And this time we don't get an error message. We can now basically go to the Chrome AI chatbot and let's see what kind of question it can answer. For example, who was the first US president? And then hopefully, yeah, we get George Washington. Perfect. So this is all offline. This doesn't require an internet connection. But what is really, really cool about it is that you can create an empty tab and just go with F12. You go into the developer console like this, and you go into the console. And we have a new object, which is called window.ai. And in there, we have this AI functionality. And we can literally say const session equals, then we can say window.ai create text session, like this. Don't let the undefined scare you off. That's the expected resolution. Then you can say const working equals await session. Enter. And that takes a little bit, but immediately we get a nothing undefined again. So we would think, this isn't working really, right? But now we can say await working. And this working object now has prompt as a function or method, so to speak. And then you can say, who was the second president of the US? Now press enter. And the second president of the US was John Adams. And this is the string that is returned. And now imagine this is your source code inside of your TMS web core application. This is JavaScript, right? So you could wrap this. You could say, hey, give me the session window AI, create text session, create the session object. And then you can, with this working, you can ask as many questions as you want. And you don't have to be connected to the internet. That's the cool thing, you know? Prompt. How many and when did the Boston Red Sox win the World Series? For example, as another question that we could pose. There you go. Takes a little bit. And as of my last knowledge update in September 2021, so that's when the model was generated that they're using right now, and they won it 5 times. Sadly, that's still correct. After 2021, they haven't won the World Series again yet. And this is so cool that you have this kind of stuff available. However, be careful. For example, if you ask, for example, working prompt, how many times did Germany win the soccer world or the World Cup of soccer compared to Brazil? And as I am originally from Germany, I know that Germany is known for its success in soccer, and they have won it quite a few times, the World Championship. And this is the answer we get from this AI. Germany has never won the FIFA World Cup. Brazil has won the World Cup the most times with 5 titles. So if I now go here into the browser and say Germany World Cup wins soccer, Germany is one of the most successful national teams in international competitions, having won 4. And the AI here claims never. So be very, very careful with this model. Don't use it in production yet. This is something that is in the labs from Google. But this is really, really cool because you can use this kind of technology now inside of your applications. It's offline. The browser downloads the model. I'm quite sure Google will make this really, really easy to update the model automatically inside of the browser. This is the future. This is the future that your browsers will get AI technology inside of this. You can also most likely ask questions that you pass in text and that the browser is supposed to summarize it. So let's say, for example, here we have Germany at the FIFA World Cup. Let's take this text right here, copy it into the clipboard. And let's say, wait, working.prompt, and then say, please summarize. And then insert a line feed, of course. Now we paste the text from the web browser. And like this, let's see if it can do this complex operation or not. Let's see if we get an answer. Summary, Germany. See, it's a summary of the text for us generated by AI. So this is really, really cool. This works today. You just have to make sure that you get the developer version of Google Chrome and that you do the steps that I've shown you in this video. So this is something that I'm quite sure TMS will follow to integrate into their browser-related products. I'm definitely going to keep my eye on it if I can incorporate it in future examples that I will present to you. This is really, really cool. I love this, and that's why I wanted to share it with you. So take care, stay tuned, bye-bye.